Hello, Sagittarius. Happy December 2015. The 18th of December is going to be 3 years since I've had this channel. So thank you all so much for watching my channel. Sagittarius rising sign, birth sign, North Node. This video is for you. I also want to mention that I will be on Periscope. So I will be starting that up. I better add the account today. And let's see. What else? What else? Yes, the full moon and new moon. So the new moon is going to be on the 11th and it is in your sign, Sagittarius. So when the moon is a new moon, it's the furthest from the earth. So in that time, we say distance, right? Getting rid, cleansing, throwing away. It's great to get rid of any negative, low energy thoughts. Clear that out. Okay, we have the Lily Sky Tarot cards. I'll be reading, and I'll pull one card from the chakra cards, right, to see which chakras are blocked and what positive message you can get from the chakras, which is all positive. So, the new moon on the 11th, I have written down here. This is a great time to rid yourself of doubt, let go of anything old, okay? And then on the 25th of December is going to be the full moon in Cancer. So even though Cancer is a water sign, there is positive messages and thoughts for all of the zodiac signs. So healing and love. So this December 25th on the full moon, maybe do meditation, something that is all about love and healing for you. All right, so Sagittarius. Let's see what the card is for you, fire signs. This is a general reading. I do have the card up right here. King of Coins. Coins, all energy is earth energy when you're dealing with the pentacles. And I call them coins on this deck. And the King of Coins. So the King of Coins, he is relaxed. He is in control and is being in control of your money. So this is all earth level energy we're dealing with here. And it's all about your finances. So where do you want to be? So really use this time to dig deep and put yourself where you want to be. And it's not a fantasy, it's really being realistic because there's always someone in control that is being realistic. And there's always someone that's like floating in the air, like la-di-da, right? So this King of Coins is saying, really get grounded, because coins, pentacles are dealing with earth energy. And it's in the card deck, you'll see an angel in the back. You'll see a treasure chest with gold. You'll see at his feet, he has books with coins on it. So he's always having little coins around, and the big coin is right there at his feet, at his throne, and he is in control, but he's relaxed. So allow yourself to be in control, but at a very relaxed level. And when you're relaxed, you get to think clearer, you get clearer thoughts, clearer ideas, you get to execute your ideas and your goal to benefit yourself in this time for you in a better way. Okay, so it's an energy and reminding you to be as calm as you can. Okay. And this is a time for you to be in control. And being in control for you, maybe looking about this form of control in a different way. So maybe you're having different plans of how you want to set up your finances. Make sure that you're researching it. You are powerful and wise enough to know your limitation, and seeking help when you need it is very, very important. So don't allow your ego to block you in doing this the right way this time. Okay, not to say that you weren't right before, but this time you want to make sure that you're going about it the right way. So let's look at what card is for you guys. So I'm going to pull this one, and it is the third eye. And the third eye, perfect, 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 perfect. So we have the King of Coins, and you're using your third eye and intuition. So this card for the third eye is talking about intuition. So allow yourself to use your imagination, but not so much your imagination. You can do that second. The first is your intuition. What do you feel deep down inside is the right move to do? And do that. Maybe sometimes you have to maybe do something else in the meantime, but you're still keeping your mind on track for what it is that you really want. And the third eye is very powerful because we're all born with that intuition. I always talk about that. Our intuition's a feeling. It's not something that you can confirm, right? Until after the fact. You're like, I knew that. I knew that. How did I know that? I don't know. I just knew it. So that's your intuition. It's the knowing without knowing, I call it. It's like, how did I know that? I just knew it. I don't know how I knew, but I knew, right? And a lot of people can say that's God, that's divine, that's angels, that's spirit guides, however you want. That is just a sense you have. You just sensed it. You watch the person's behavior. It was just a feeling you got. You know, animals, I always say, have that. They're way better at sensing their environment than humans are. We're so distracted with technology and a lot of other stuff, and we're just not really taught to be aware of things. And anything can happen, but when you feel it, you feel it and you know it. So definitely do use your intuition. Sagittarius, you're great at that. So, like I said, I'll see you on Periscope. I hope you guys will join me there. And have a happy December. Thank you guys for 3 years. And I have a couple things coming up, so I'm just really excited. Thank you guys for your support, and I'll see you next time.